Busia District has reported an increase in cases of fistula condition among childbearing mothers. A fistula can cause many complications such as urinary and fecal leakage, abnormal vaginal discharge, tissue damage, kidney infections, and other irritative type symptoms in affected individuals. A report from the maternity ward at Masafu General Hospital indicates that 85 mothers were detected with complications related to fistula in September last month. The cases were most common among teenage mothers aged 14 to 19. Dr. Emmanuel Tusime, the medical superintendent of Masafu General Hospital, says they're registering between 2 to 3 cases weekly, with the most affected districts being Namayingo, Bujiri, Tororo, and Busia.
These are birth injuries or conditions that are arising out of birth or delivery. Some girls get pregnant very early and they end up with complications during delivery. But also there are delays that are created by maybe the system. An example, someone maybe is she gets pregnant, goes into labor and gets obstructed labor and delays to be worked on.
Judith Tucker, the midwife in charge of maternity ward at Masafu General Hospital, attributes the rise in cases to delays by expectant mothers to report in health facilities while in labor pain. She added that currently they are conducting a free fistula medical camp organized by the Ministry of Health, and out of 40 screened mothers, 10 have been subjected to surgery for fistula.
And so far, by yesterday, we had a big number of around 40 mothers that were screened, and 10 already were identified with fistulas. So this shows that we already have a big number of our mothers who are in the community, and they have this problem, but some of them may not have been aware. But with the ongoing sensitization about the fistula, because how do you get the fistula? These fistulas happen when you become pregnant and as a result of delivery.
Risfa Nekesa, a patient with fistula condition, says she was affected by the condition in her 6th child and she has come to the hospital to get treatment. Scholastic Mujeni and Annette Natojo are among the mothers who spoke to our reporter in the maternity ward. They say that they are sometimes misled by traditional birth attendants, and they advised fellow mothers to embrace giving birth in health facilities. Said Bwire and Peter Samuel are family men who shared their experiences on the impact of fistula conditions in their families. They say that because the affected woman in a home cannot perform other roles normally, this has given a rise to domestic violence.
Then, taking to Sabulunjo Resonga, a chin to a jit sovola over Tatugata Wabu, Ninsovala no Kufino Mucharo Murada, always song a rimaka, always on Gomusaka Muchara Babanga Muradim Maka, Tosovala Kuveda inside.
Tuleta munyuka wakati wa mkazi wangu kitetuleta munyumba kwa kati tukwatagana bulungi munyumba.
The United Nations estimate that at least 2 million women live with fistula in developing countries, with 50,000 to 100,000 new cases occurring each year. The Ugandan government has taken important steps to address this issue. In 2011, the country enacted the National Obstetric Fistula Strategy 2011-2012 to 2015-2016, which aims to guide the implementation of prevention, treatment, and reintegration activities for obstetric fistula. This has led to increased awareness, training of specialized fistula surgeons, and the establishment of dedicated fistula repair centers across the country.